Welcome for the 20th session. Well, this evening is very interesting. We have got a very, very, very powerful orator. You will love to listen to this gentleman. His knowledge, his experience is something which will rock you. From being a child of a landless farmer who grew with a slate in one hand and a plate in the other hand, because that's how he lived his childhood. He used to go to the school because he used to get the plate. The midday meal scheme of the state helped him to study. From there, to be a man today of 2,000 crores. 2,000 crores, Dr. Velumani. I would like to request him to join me on the dais. And he's a very powerful orator. You will be getting to listen to some dialogues which will be better than Rajnikant dialogues. His experience speaks volumes. He's heard all over the country and the world. And we are going to enjoy that experience today. He's being from Coimbatore, from a place called Sulur, which is again a beautiful place, very close to Coimbatore. And his village from Sulur is 5 kilometers away. A man who came to Mumbai in 1982 on the 18th of August, slept at the VT railway station for 4 days, from 18th August to 22nd August, by mistake wore leather shoes and came to Mumbai when it was raining, because he was used to living in Chennai, which didn't have rainfall. So he committed a mistake of buying shoes instead of an umbrella, and he spoiled his leather shoes in the rain of Mumbai. From there to this journey, this is what we are going to discuss. Here is Dr. Velumani.
Thank you very much.
Your best luxury of life was your poverty. I'm sure you were inspired and motivated with the poverty that you faced. And how have you channelized that to the mountainous growth that you have achieved?
I think I have been telling luxury of poverty. You all must be thinking luxury is different, poverty is different. But actually luxury of poverty. Success in life is a delta. Delta is x2 minus x1. x2 is where you are today, x1 is where you were that day. And if x1 was 0, will you ever lose? Lucky are those who are born to poor. And if people say that, you know, my father was poor, they are grumbling. Celebrate. So that's what I call as poverty. And if you know you are rich, you have fear of falling, losing. And if you are already poor, there is no downside. Right? So I believe that the guys who had poverty have all the reasons to succeed, and the guys who have been rich have all the reason to lose it also. Nature is nature.
So are you thankful that you failed in 50 job interviews and you could not get a single job, and you came to Bombay to the city of magic, where dreams get created and recreated every moment? Are you happy? Because if you would have passed one interview of that 50, you would have been still in Coimbatore.
I still passed one interview and I got a job. Fortunately, that company also was closed down. And why I didn't get job in 50 companies, you must know the reason. Two reasons. Everybody asked, do you have an experience? Kaunsi college hote hain, jahan experience milti hai? It's only the degree you get. So I was just frustrated. The next one is, everybody is asking a question in English. I was in a vernacular medium. So they were only testing the English. English is a language. It's not knowledge. I don't think any HR man understands. Everybody is testing English.
years of working as an employee with the BARC, as a research scientist, one fine night, I think you love the nights, because even your laboratories, every night, all night, before midnight, before daylight. So, one night, 15 years back in 1995, you surprised your wife by saying that you are not going to the office the next day and you have resigned.
Even in case of marriage, people talk first night, not the first day.
So, he has explained that concept very interestingly. 15 years back in one night, his wife and they were both horizontal on the bed. He told her, I have quit the job. Tomorrow onwards, I have resigned. I'm not going to the office. She became vertical. Then she said, if you're not going to job from tomorrow, she was a banker with the SBI. She said, even I will not go to the job from tomorrow. So he got vertical. And in one night, husband and wife couple decided that they quit the job and they plunged into business.
Absolutely. And mind you, I did not plan to resign. Decision to resign was instantaneous.
So he's a fantastic decision maker as an entrepreneur. So rather than discussing and then deciding, he decides and then discusses, right?
I want to tell you, there are four things which are in this philosophy. I left home in 1982 without discussing with my father. If you discuss with your father, anyhow, he's not going to allow you to go to at least Mumbai from Tamil Nadu. In 1986, I got married without discussing with my mother. I'm sure all of you must be thinking it was a love marriage. But actually, my father-in-law loved me. He persuaded me. Only thing is, my mother's dream was she should be a fair girl. And in my village, why did I persuade and become a graduate? Because in that village, or in that town, nearby towns, all graduates are fair-looking wives. Now I became a MSc, then I became a PhD. The color is very important for my mother. And if I discuss, she will fail. So what did I do? I took her to a good studio, put bright light and took a photograph. My mother okayed it. Only 2 days before the marriage when she came, she made a hallagulla. She couldn't stop the marriage. Third thing, I resigned without telling my wife. If you tell your wife, you never discuss with the spouse. Had I told my father-in-law would have come and asked, Gade, government officer garika ladki diya abhi kya natak hai. So I took a decision to resign without discussing with my wife. I started charging 100 rupees for thyroid testing when entire country was charging 500 rupees. This was also a decision. Had I discussed, people would have daravi karega. I just took a decision. And mind you, there are only two kinds of people, one who decided and succeeded, other one who discussed and failed.
Fantastic. So I think decision making is one of your powers. So you decide and you take the decision that it's done. So you are not only Dr. Velumani, you are Dr. Volumani. You believe in volumes.
No, you are totally wrong. I am Velumani. You split the name into two. It is value and money.
You got into the business of volumes, and when the market was 700, 800 rupees a test, you started offering it at 150 rupees and you captured the market.
Absolutely.
So you decided, instead of charging the customer more, you decided to take more discounts from the vendors and pass it on to the customers. Were you mathematically right in the beginning, or it was a decision that you stuck to and made it right?
Profits are everywhere. Pricing is just a philosophy. Profits are everywhere. Pricing is just a philosophy. The pyramid of society, economically, has 10 slices. You price high, you are catering to slice 1 and 2. Price low, you are in 4, 5, 6. You have priced by mistake too low, you are in slice 7 and 8. Mind you, there is a fortune in the bottom of the pyramid, not in the top of the pyramid. So I somehow, I'm a philosopher now because I'm successful.
Because you're successful, yeah. If you'd have said this
earlier,
before 1995,
people would have told I'm a crazy guy.
Fantastic. When you began your journey with only 2 lakhs in the bank account, you began your business and you didn't have machines for your pathology. So the deal that you strike with the first doctor at Kemp's Corner in Mumbai, who gave you the machines and you gave him free tests, and the balance time you did business in the open market, that was a fantastic strategy. Did you decide it on the spot after seeing the doctor, or you made a plan and then met him?
I think the business men, there are three kinds of people. One who can see what others can see. Other man cannot see what others can see. And one more man who can see what others cannot see. He only is an entrepreneur. So when I found a doctor who is doing a thyroid testing 5 samples a day, has parked a machine which can do 500 samples a day. I told him, I'll get you 5 tests free, done for 5 years. You give me that medicine. Who said to do business you need money? You need stamina, you need intelligence. So I got that medicine, worked on volume. That machine is busy. Went and knocked one more, and a dozen machines I could get without paying. Mind you, the business overall is successful simply because I understood Ola concept that time itself. You know what is Ola concept? Normally, taxis were standing for 20 hours and running for 4 hours before Ola came in. Today, they are running for 20 hours and standing for 4 hours, right? Analyzers, testing machines were testing for 1 hour in a day, standing for 23 hours in a day. Today, I make machines to run 23 hours and they stand 1 hour for service. Mind you, sweat the asset, sweat the brain, prosperity is there.
Fantastic, fantastic. In 1995, you thought that let me take advantage of technology and the mobility of logistics, air cargo. And you started in Vashi and started collecting samples from a couple of 100 cities of the country. That was a very smart move. So did that step help you to achieve volumes because of which you could charge low to your vendors, to your partners in terms of pathology, laboratories, hospitals, etc.?
One thing I knew very clearly, reagent cost is like a broadband cost. The smaller you buy, costlier it is. Bigger bandwidth, cheaper per kbps. So I knew that every time when if I double the volume, I get a 10% discount. Even today it is working. So every time you double the volume, 10% discount. And let me give you what made me to work on this. Everybody was buying reagent for $3 and selling the services for $10. Fair business. Reagent $3, conversion cost $3, selling with $4 margin, $10. I bought reagent for $3 and rolled out my service for $2. So people were wondering, this man is fundamentally wrong. Aisa, hoyega, the $3 reagent cost, his services are $2. But none of them knew that if you buy 100 a month, it is $3. You buy 1,000 a month, it is $2.5. Buy 10,000 a month, it is $2. Today, I buy 5 million tests a month, it is $0.50. And that's the story.
Why did you, in spite of being the cheapest in the country, in terms of pricing, not quality, you still further went ahead and reduced your prices from $1 a test to $0.50? What was the idea behind that?
Yeah, this was one evening when my daughter in a dinner table asked me a question, Daddy, are you rich? I said, I'm rich, very rich, very rich. What are you going to do with the money? I said, like, Bill Gates, Azim Premji, I also should bluff, sorry, talk. So I said, I will give it to the society. So my daughter asked me, are you not an idiot? Loot the patient and give it to the society. Actually, you should loot from the society and give it to the patient. It struck me like anything. So I did think the entire night, didn't sleep, and took a decision that instead of collecting $2, I will collect $1. My investors were quite shocked. On the boardroom, they asked me a question. You mean to say you want to do charity when we have come on the board? I told, look, profits will go up. No. Finally, I arm twisted. And after 18 months, they said, Doc, you are a visionary. Because profits went up.
It went up to 42%?
You reduce the price, the profits go up. I think this is something which is one has to experience. So the profits went to 40% up, and IPO got subscribed 75 times.
So Thyrocare is a zero debt company. In 2011, you got funds on board as equity funding. And to exit them, you created the
IPO.
What was the reason for you to raise the funds in 2011? And why did you exit them in 2016?
There is a saying, people say, had I not met that lady that day, I would have not had this child. So was my story. Somebody came, asked for a share. My share, I felt, should my company should be worth 200 crore. But I didn't want to sell. So I said 400 crore. The guys went away. After 6 months, they came back. I knew that I had told the right price. So when they came back, I told 500 crore. They were a bit shocked. I told, do quarter acha gaya. To 400, 500 ban gaya. This time they were very angry. They didn't even ask for a coffee. They went away. After two more quarters, they again came. 600. This time they wrote a paper and pencil and told, okay, that day, and I not met them, this deal would have not happened. So I diluted at 600 crore, 25%. So that is to know what is my true value. Not for anything else, number one. Number two, if you want money, you will get only 20% less. If you don't want money, you get 20% more. I got it.
So you went laughing to the bank in 2011 and they went laughing to bank in 2016.
Absolutely.
People are laughing, buying the shares and the price increasing, and they are also enjoying the growth in the stock prices.
See, ultimately, if the concept is good, the DNA is good, that means the seed is good and everybody is going to benefit.
Fantastic.
So it is important that no business will be sold, no business can be, camouflaged and sold. You have to have a good concept, good product. You have to have good story, and you should be a good storyteller. So these are all important in becoming a powerful entrepreneur.
Fantastic. You like the digit 6 and 0. Every 6 years you add a 0 to your turnover. In the year 95, you started with 1 crore. Your turnover was 1 crore. After 6 years, it became 10. After another 6 years, it went on adding 0. If I'll ask you now, what is your next mission? You will say another 0. So what is the logic behind the 6 and 0, and why not any other digit?
There are only two kinds of people on this earth. One who chases 0, other who remains 0.
I told you, even Rajnikant will need tuitions.
I hope he is not hearing. Let me tell you.
And I hope he's hearing.
Somebody is writing his dialogue and nobody wrote my dialogue.
He makes films where somebody else is producing. You will be probably producing your own film. That's the difference of creating wealth. Dr. Velumani, you strongly believe in two powerful words, focus and stamina. So what do you mean by focus? Because wealth creation has got different roots. What Bill Gates did with 2 lakh people, Warren Buffett does it with 25 people. Richard Branson does it with more than 200 companies. So there is no fixed formula for wealth creation, whereas you very firmly believe that to be successful in any line of business, you need to have core focus, and to sustain that, you need to have the stamina. So what are your beliefs about focus and stamina?
Kuch kone ke liye tayar nahi to kuch pa nahi sakte hain. So I took a decision. I didn't start my laboratory as Dr. Vail Path Lab. I started my laboratory as Thyrocare. It was only a 15-gram gland, 3 hormones. So people were wondering, tumhe roti milega kya? And I sensed India has a billion thyroid. I will become 1,000 crore company. I must tell you, the one who cares for kidney should not look at liver just because liver is sitting on the kidney. Focus gives success. Today, all over the country, thyroid means think thyroid, think Thyrocare. I'm very, very happy. And that gave me success. Today, all valuation, all amplifications, all because of focus. And let me tell you, if you don't focus, you can't get your 10th standard marks well. If you don't focus, 12th is Gaya. If you don't focus, your wife has resigned. If you don't focus, sorry, divorced. If you don't focus, your boss has thrown you out. And let me tell you, the only single word on this earth most powerful is focus. And I want that to be understood very clearly and get into the focus. If you do many things, you will survive. If you do one thing, you will be the leader.
So you promote entrepreneurship where you focus on one line of business and become the king of that business, like how you have done for Thyrocare.
I think wherever I have seen Madurai, Arvind Eye Hospital, only I. If you look at somebody who has focused on a specific one particular domain, leader banega hi.
So shall we start multiplying Thyrocare, thyroid 15 grams, lungs 2 kgs, multiply?
Absolutely.
That's the maths?
No, there is one more maths.
What
want to listen? Aaj tak, I have not heard anybody died because of a thyroid problem. I made
right
3,000 crore. And diabetes, 50% of the people die because of diabetes. So you can make $30 billion brand. So don't compare like this. Arithmetics works in many ways.
So this 15 grams helped you to reach across the country, helped you to reach Bahrain, helped you to reach Bangladesh, and you want to do the McDonald's model where you want to go to Seattle and Atlanta also. What are your expansion plans?
I think the word focus is very clear. McDonald's. Do they make masala dosa? Katha. I think focus is, I met once Azim Premji and he asked me in a breakfast table, you tell me in simple words, Thyrocare. I said, it's McDonald's plus Walmart. McDonald's because of the focus, Walmart because of the volume. Done.
Volume money.
Volume money.
Fantastic. With Walmart, I think you studied them and you read them and understood the distribution power. The power of distribution, scalability, going geographically, controlling the market. Is that what you saw in Walmart?
Absolutely not. Because I never knew what is Walmart when I started a business. I have not been knowing McDonald's when I started a business. And I didn't know what is the spelling of entrepreneur when I started the business. Today, startup, angel, venture,
seed money,
Velu money, never seed any money. I only found one thing, lager ago. Get into something, focus. I think if you remain focused, sirf, aankho se ye patthar mein hole girega.
Fantastic. So you created the central kitchen, that couple of restaurants started that concept couple of years back. It was a hit formula. Have a centralized kitchen. That's what McDonald's does. You created a central kitchen in the industry of medical profession.
Laboratory.
And that became super successful to bring down the costings. Now across India, you have got a 2 lakh square feet at Vashi. And across India, you have got around 3 to 4 such mega centers.
I have 6 of them.
You have got 6 of them currently. And yes, you have covered more of South India.
No, all over India.
Delhi. Your biggest is Delhi.
Biggest market is Delhi.
So how do you map your growth? Does it happen with a plan or does it happen accidentally? Or do you work on database which can help you?
Jo research karta hai, wo kabhi jeetta nahi hai.
Being a research scientist, you are saying that.
I understood research is nothing but again and again search. Right? I have never done any research. My network got like this. First, I made some of my friends as franchisees. Then they are successful. So their relatives all became franchisees. Then I made some of my relatives franchisees. They were successful. Then their friends all. So I have got 1,200 people across the country who are somebody's relations or friends. And this is the most powerful network. I have never advertised that I want franchisee. And we reached a $500 million brand without a marketing department.
Fantastic. Because you are not You are not into the B2C market, you are in the B2B market. So a lot of vendors come attracted to you because of the low price and their margins improving, right? But I think you have also started the B2C market.
Let me tell you, how did I make this very unique, very powerful? I don't see a competition at all. There are only two kinds of people, one who sees opportunity, enjoys, other who sees the competition and suffers. So I did not see the competition because all others are pathologists, I'm a biochemist. All others are focused on diseases, I am focused on disorder. All of them are focused on acute illnesses, I am focused on chronic illness. All of them are having their patients in clinic or hospital, I have it at home and office. All their patients are horizontal, my patients are vertical and walking. There is no competition. So literally speaking, literally speaking, all of them are focused on 1% of the sick patient, I am focused on 99% of the healthy patients. All of them have a competition of 100,000 laboratories. Rajnikant.
So you are the kabali of the pathology industry.
I just don't want to steal all the thunder only from that gentleman. But having said that, he has some few punch dialogues which have really remind us cornerstone for my journey. Yam vali tani vali, which means mera rasta alagi hai. The next one is every stumbling block in your life can become stepping stone if you're intelligent. So people only see it as a stumbling block and get blocked, and I saw all as stepping stones and I made it. And be humble, be simple, uncomplicate. These are all a few things. I think Tamil movies had a tremendous, I think the difference between North and South movies. North movies, dacoits, revenge, rape, chase, whereas South, it is a brother, sister, mother, daughter, father, love, affection. I think makes a lot of sense. And today I attribute a lot to those days which I saw cinema. I saw cinema only till I understood all of them are acting.
Fantastic. So logistics has been the backbone of your business, because major of your business happens on air logistics, air cargo. Did you strategize it right from the beginning when you initiated the idea that you should spread across the country by using air cargo? How did that happen? Because every growth in business has a strategy behind it. Did you strategically define it?
No. Aap seedha chalte raho, seedha sochte raho. Finally, you will find somebody else listing all your strategies. You didn't know all them their strategies.
So is that your strategy?
I went to Chennai. I was trying to set up a laboratory there because business was not adequate there. I found setting a laboratory once again is very painful. I went to the airport and booked the consignment. When I got down, I picked up the consignment. And I went and processed this. Next day, I told guys, please go and book the consignment every evening. Mind you, all of you must be thinking that the air cargo means very costly. Air cargo charges around 3,000 to 4,000 rupees for 10 kilograms. And if you have 2,000 samples in it is 1 rupee per sample. Everything is volume. Everything is an exponential curve. Everything is a pyramid. So mathematician sees life very different. And if you hated mathematics, go and restart. Without mathematics, you just can't achieve anything.
You believe a lot in frugal living. In fact, you don't even have a house. Your house is a part of your complex. And the distance between his bedroom and his conference room is 10 meters. So in the 2 lakh square feet in Vashi, you live in a house which is 5,000 square feet connected to your office so that you are available 24/7. What are your thoughts about frugal living? How does it affect an entrepreneur?
Had I bought a house, I could have not done this business. Because once you buy a house, you get an EMI. You want to listen what is heaven? Heaven is clutter-free brain, fear-free mind, and EMI-free life. Had I had EMI, I would have not dared to resign the job. So I didn't buy a house. Today I read a book which tells either you can buy a house or you can do business, not both. Very powerful one. Because when you finish your EMI, this side has become white. So I didn't buy a house. Then afterwards, I was sitting and analyzing, had my father had a good house, would I have left the home? No. Jiska, don't get me wrong, main thoda dialogue baji maar deta hun. Jiska paas ghar hai, wo bandha hua bains hai. Jiska paas ghar nahi hai, wo khula bains hai.
Is that a message or an information? That's a very smart way to do, and definitely when you have got 2 lakh square feet office and a 5,000 square feet house in that office, why do you need a separate home? So I'm sure it will be state of the art and connected to.
Yeah, we are.
It must have designed by Siemens.
We are broadband connected.
All the time.
All 4 members in my family are broad minded and broadband connected.
All in the same campus.
And we live in the same campus. We're never traveling. Driver ki jarurat nahi hai, gaadi ki jarurat nahi hai, ghar ko bhi jarurat nahi hai. And mind you, this is the best way to balance between work and life. Get your wife to the office.
Some people did that and closed their businesses.
And let me tell you, there are some people who are successful.
Because they brought their wife.
Successful. After becoming successful, the secretary becomes the wife. Other guys make wife as secretary, and I had my wife as secretary almost throughout the journey.
Fantastic, fantastic. So there you are tied down.
You can tell that you are tied down, and also you are energized. If your spouse trusts you, it means your energy is amplified 100 times. If she just questions you, that means the energy has come down 10 times down. It's very important, and I was very lucky to have my wife who said, "Chalo saath jiyenge, saath marenge." That is the reason on which we took the decision to leave the job.
Superb, superb, superb. So friends, let us start having questions from the audience. There is a lot of audience today. Let us have some interesting questions, and we will get going with answers from Dr. Velumani. Let's begin.
I want the questions to be shorter than the answers.
In one statement.
Good evening, sir. Anyway, entire session was in the lighter vein, so I am asking a question also in a lighter vein. So don't feel bad. When Rajesh told that is a connection of 6, so your issue price at the IPO was also 446. Whether there was any link?
Right, the IPO price is not decided by me. It is decided by the lead managers, bankers, and all those guys. So not decided by me. But I think you said in a lighter vein. I will also add something more in lightest vein. You know where from we get our business? When we find a vein and give some pain, we get some gain. That's blood collection business.
Yes, next question. Yeah, Sidhu.
Good evening, sir. My question is that when the prices of the test were rupees 500, you started at 100. So was the idea to make a loss and gain customers, or was it to get down the inflated price?
Up a million. If you don't lose a million, you can't make a billion. Many people think it's a straight line. Business means straight line. Business means it's a hockey stick. Where first you jugna padta hai, kona padta hai, traction chahiye. So these are all essential in business. So I did understand that, but fortunately for me, within 6 months, business became viable. So it all depends. The minute, you know, today you see first ride free, A free, O free, what does that mean?
You need burning money.
Habit.
They burn money, I burn stamina. In life, you have 2 options. You can burn calories or you can burn salaries.
When you said hockey stick, there was a broad smile on ACP Vasan Doble's face. Because that has been his symbol for the last 40 years. If he'll contest election, his symbol is going to be hockey stick. Yeah, Vivek.
Yes, doctor. We see the half-page ads of Thyrocare, but like Metropolis and Dr. Lal's pathology library, we don't see the actual labs. So why the difference in the model?
See, I said their patients are in nursing home and hospital are influenced by a doctor for a decision making. You cannot see an advertisement of streptomycin and teramycin. You can see an advertisement of Horlicks and Bonvita. I am Horlicks and Bonvita. We are into preventive care. We are into wellness. So our product is advertisable. They are also into my space, but they are into pathology. Pathology means a doctor need to doubt a disease and treat a disease. So I think, as I said, they are pathologists. I'm a biochemist. So some kind of difference is there. But who said they don't advertise? They also put up hoardings. They also put up radio. They also put up everything. It is happening. Only thing, I was ahead.
Fantastic. Yes. Rohit.
Yeah, doctor, I'm listening to you twice. I just heard you in NSC. You made a massive growth. So did that create any enmity in the marketplace? And how did you handle that?
I think enmity was there in the industry. Because if you don't spoil the sleep of 10 people, you can't give a solution to 1,000 people. If you don't spoil the sleep of 10 people, you can't give a solution to 1,000 people. So I did that, not intentionally. Whenever you disrupt, something is getting disrupted. But in the society, I didn't have any bad or any enemies. I think I was minding my business, so I don't have any competitors. Irritators. But in the industry, people know that this man is unnecessarily spoiling. And it is...
Did you have any impact on you? Or did anyone try to threaten you or something?
Aam kabhi dara nahi hai.
Shabash.
Darane wala jyada darata hai toh mera confidence badh jati hai.
You are super Rajnikant.
Thank you.
That is the advantage of having the house in the office.
Yes.
Miloge toh daraoge na?
Yeah.
Yes, next question please. Nagu.
Doctor. Jaichadu karanam veriya strategy ya?
Sit down. I'll give you a wonderful answer. Whenever an employee comes to my office, I ask him, Jina aya ya Jeetne aya?
What was the question?
Jina aya ya Jeetne aya? I'll come to that.
Question, I asked you in Tamil. I wanted to do that.
Tamil.
And we are not in Coimbatore. So.
Yeah. Yeah. So the question was, did he succeed because of his fierceness to grow or a strategy?
No, I tell it in Tamil. Asa yallarukku irukku. Very yallarukatti irukkadu. Asa irukkaram thungi irupan. Very irukkaram mulichit irupan. So Jina aya wo kaake so jayega. Jo Jeetne aya wo kabhi soyega nahi hai. The next question. I ask my employees. Sadne aya ya chadne aya? The third question, I ask them, Buddha hona hai ya bada hona hai? Buddha hona hai toh mehnat karne ki jaroorat hi nahi hai. Bada hona hai toh so nahi sakta hai. Oh, all my boys are every day motivated, energized, and they do a wonderful job.
So he has an auditorium in the 2 lakh square feet office where he keeps motivating his team of almost 600 people at the place, I suppose. And he's such a powerful orator and a great storyteller. He motivates them so much that they have to be reminded to take their salaries. And I went a step ahead. This kind of motivation, they might start paying to Thyrocare. That is the power of his oratory, self-confidence, focus, stamina, leading by example, being in the front all the time. I think that's amazing. Kunal.
Yeah. Today we see Thyrocare has a lot of systems in place for everything. The reports, how it is delivered. Initially, when you started, how did you manage this coordination and what was the systems in place? How did you ensure initially the service was as good as it is today?
I today lift a buffalo. That day, I lifted only a buffalo calf, which was 6-7 kilos. And I kept lifting buffalo every day. Didn't give a single day break. So today, I am lifting an adult buffalo. So started 10 samples, do it, learn it. 100 samples, you learned it, you amplify it. 1,000 samples, you have an experience. No one knows how to run business in future. Everyone knows how to run business now. Every month you must learn, every year you must learn, so that you are continuing to grow. Learning is a process where people fail when they become, when they see 5 crores. You know, plenty of business you must be seeing, everybody reached a 5 crore and stopped because they stopped learning. And continue to learn. I'm a mathematician, so brought in IT. There are plenty of things. Lucky are those who are born to poor. Because in poor means what? There was no resources, so you managed. Is that right? Poverty is no resources, you manage. Business is what? Low resources, you manage. There has never been a jerk. Mine was zero automation for first 7 years. And then today I am having an automation which no laboratory in the country has. Jabhi paisa nahi tha, focus karke, mehnat karke, I was doing the test involved. Then I understood after this volume, it is not easy to run the business without investing on automation. Tab tak itna paisa aa gaya, paisa ko bhi kya karunga. So today I have got the state of the art. So to do business, you don't need money. You need stamina. Then stamina gives you business. You get money. So it all happens. You must start with stamina. And let me add the Rajnikant punch in it. Jiska paas stamina hota hai, woh na baap se darta hai, ya baas se darta hai.
I think you have the longest track in the world for a pathological laboratory.
This is Siemens project, which they say that worldwide there is no such a big track anywhere.
So what Coimbatore people did for their cotton industries or their textile industries, you duplicated that better than that with automation for the pathological laboratories,
exactly.
Right? Exactly. That's what you did and you achieved. Yeah. And Siemens kind of a brand being partnering with you is definitely a big leap in life because Siemens is a great brand.
Actually, you didn't show that video program which Siemens have taken and they are showing to the entire world. Volume money
and value money,
that says if you want to do big business, volume business, look at this man. They are selling me across the country
and selling their machines,
selling their, obviously,
fantastic. Yes, Pradeep.
Good evening, sir. From what you said in the beginning, you started as a very poor man, you didn't have anything. So that was a very, very good reason why you succeeded. So in other words, you're saying you have capitalized on the power of zero. You didn't have anything, so you were very powerful. So you did all the hockey stick models, the 500 thing you sold for 100 and all that, but now you don't have the power of zero. So is there a change in strategy? Is there a change in outlook?
Aapka sawal ye hona chahiye, abhi kone ka dar hai kya? Chahiye?
That is what he means. That is what he means, yeah.
Mera paas, main laya kya tha koke jane ke liye? What did I bring to Bombay that I will lose and go? Nothing. Idhar hi jo banaya, idhar hi koonga. And I have decided to lose whatever I have made. I don't think anybody can stop me.
Your son is here?
He should be around in another 5 minutes. Or he has come hiding somewhere, I don't know. Yeah, he's there. And I must tell you here, कोने का जो डरता है वो कोई जाते हैं, जो कोना चाहते हैं वो कभी खोता नहीं है. दिस इज नेचर. सो आई डोंट हैव अ फियर. इन फैक्ट आई टेक बिगर रिस्क टुडे. सो इफ यू आस्क मी, हैज मनी मेड यू स्कर्ड? एब्सोल्युटली नॉट टिल डेट. हैविंग सेड दैट, नाम कोने के लिए डर है, पैसा कोने के डर नहीं है.
या विनीत.
गुड इवनिंग सर. I've heard you earlier and you said you hire a lot of, recruit a lot of freshers. How do you manage which freshers?
Yeah, you want to know why I recruit only freshers? Because I failed in 50 interviews.
So you made your HR policy then?
I made an HR policy. I will not take any experienced guy in my company. So for all the 800 people, I am the first employer. So this is a philosophy in which I have gone. Mind you, my business is 90% process oriented, 10% intellectually capable people can do. Whenever you have a system which is process oriented, you can take a fresher and within 100 days he is powerful enough to be a part of the process. Whenever it is intellectual, you need guys with an ability to think and strategize and work. So any man I get, 10 people have intelligence, they get into there. Remaining people lack intelligence, they are into operation. Mind you, every year you keep taking 20% employees new, that means your company will never die.
Fresh blood.
Fresh blood. Mean age of the employee is minus 24 and a half. Can you imagine 20-year-old organization has a mean age of 24.5? Lagate jao, pyramid mein, niche se 20%. Very powerful method of growing the business. Young are very capable, powerful, dynamic, energyful.
Would this risk-taking would be never-ending?
Yeah, if you feel you have succeeded, stop taking risks. If you feel one more zero is possible, you take some risk. You need to identify a right risk and romance with it if you are an entrepreneur. In life, there is only two options. One is security, another is prosperity. You can't have both.
Thank you, sir.
But Arvind, there is no risk, man. Money is just coming in, zero debt, no home, no car, no EMI to pay. Where is the risk?
You know why you frugal?
It's only adding zero. That's why frugal.
Frugality gives you courage. And if you are a consumer, you are scared. There is an MGR song, 1968, which says, all children at birth are creators. If they become consumers, it is because of the parents and grandparents.
Yes.
Good evening, sir. I'm Sushant. Amazing success story of disruptive innovation. And what I could learn from the entire discussion that we had is you have always trusted your gut feeling and your intuition. So where do you get this energy to, you know, that your intuition or your gut feeling is right and which has given you such a success throughout the career?
So your question is, where do you get energy?
Yeah. Energy, and how do you ensure
luxury
that
luxury of poverty, number one. Next one, where do you lose your energy? I didn't get energy. I used my energy. If you ask me the question, it is likely that you lost your energy somewhere else. Somebody asked me, how you are courageous? I asked him, who made you scared? Somebody asked me, how do you maintain your health? How do you spoil it? Energy is with every individual. The more you want, the more you invest your energy. You have been left out with infinite energy and a finite time. Utilize it.
Glenn, this is the last question. Glenn.
Good evening, sir. Actually, I am a second generation entrepreneur. And unfortunately, since you have said, born with a silver spoon and bandha hua bhais also. So what you're saying is absolutely right, that, you know, the luxury of poverty is absolutely necessary, and we see a higher failure rate of second generation entrepreneurs, maybe going at a failure rate maybe because of this. So what would be your advice, because I know a lot of us are second generation here, to ensure that sustenance, you know?
I got an answer before you finished your question. One day I was sitting in a dinner table and I was discussing with my family, and my son was not doing very well in 12th standard. So I told my son, look, my grandfather was very rich, because of which my father became very poor. Because my father was very poor, I became very rich. Now I am worried about you. So he observed a silence for 100 seconds. And then he told, Daddy, I'm very happy. Why? My son will be very rich. So that is the only hope.
Dr. Rajesh.
Good evening, sir. It's always a pleasure to listen to you. Sir, I'd like to know the Velumani who came first time to Bombay and the Velumani today. What is the difference?
Velumani who came to Mumbai did not know Hindi, Marathi, Gujarati. I know Hindi, Marathi, Gujarati now. I didn't know biology, microbiology, biochemistry, cardiology, endocrinology. Now I know all of them. And I didn't know life. I know life now. I was only 43 kilos. Today I am 82 kilos. And I had only 500 rupees in my pocket those days. Today I have enough of wealth. Other than this, I am more bold, more courageous than ever I was.
So the difference was also the valuation, Rajesh. The valuation then and the valuation now. I think
I want to take another 100 seconds. I must tell you what made me powerful, what made me successful, who made me so big a personality is my wife. I lost her just 5 months back for pancreatic cancer. And she was the true power behind my success. Thank you very much. It was a wonderful evening spending time with you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Velumani. That was awesome. I would like to request Vishnu to come up on the stage and hand over a memento. I would also like to request Pradeep to come over. I would like to request the honorable chief guest to cut the memento of a cake on this auspicious 20th one.
Days before I met you, when I let you walk into my heart. Congratulations and celebrations when I tell everyone that you're in love with me.
Dr. Velumani, it was very, very, very nice of you. Historic for us. It's our 20th session and you really rocked the show. Thanks a lot for being a part of Inspiring Conversations.